The focus system is a tricky little thing, and the reason I'm starting it in a safe place here is because I keep getting wrong for not starting these by turning around and saying spoilers. Because, well, the focus system, you have to have completed the second quest. If you haven't, this is just going to be full of insane spoilers because you're going to not know what's going on. So, yeah, I wouldn't recommend doing the second quest before actually watching this at all. While doing the second quest, you will obviously be given, close to the end, a choice of 5 different schools of focus, if you wish. And each one is completely different. The one I went with was Neuroman, just because it kind of threw that out at us twice to the questions asked. It seems to be that the one in the middle is the one that it recommends, depending on the questions that you ask. You can, of course, once you've done that, actually change to any of them. Once you've actually put some stuff and unlocked it, you can. Until then, you can't really. We'll get onto that in a second, because as you can clearly tell, I have not done a thing to this because I was saving it for doing this. Starting with the Maduri. No idea what that one means. That's the skill tree for it, and basically what happens is you've got this little icon in the bottom right. When you activate it, your operator comes in and does the special ability for whichever tree you have set as your main one at the time. This one, it unleashes a destructive beam that inflicts high damage to any target in its path. This is the one you see a lot of people having. And you can also see there's passives for it. It has increased puncture damage for the duration of the mission. These activate once the operator has appeared, that is. Greater impact damage and greater slash damage, which, you know, that basically increases all your damage types if you activate, have all 3 activated. And it's also got one that splits into 3 beams, but I have yet to see anybody using it. But these things are kind of getting in the way. Because, yeah, I've tried recording videos in the past, and all of a sudden, ta-da, operators just appear in. It's like, ah! That's a bit much of a spoiler. Then there is Vizarin. This is a pretty weird one. It unleashes several waves of restorative energy, healing nearby allies. Its passives basically bounce damage back to the people dealing it to you, increases the range in which the allies can actually, the affinity, because there's a range cap. If enemies are outside of that range and somebody kills them, you don't get any experience from them. It increases that range. And New Moon is a weird one. It grants the ability to revive fallen allies instantly, up to several times for the duration of the mission. Once this has been cast for the first time, that is. As well as the other side of it, they're the passives, the other side gets pretty weird, down to the point of you will have a shell of protective energy around you, and what is it? You can restore your shields quicker, like instantly once you do this, or some weirdness. And then it grants allies a protective shell, basically. It's like Mag's Augment does pretty much the same thing. Then there is Neuroman, which, as I said earlier, is the one that I went with just because it was the one that was in the middle. I even said that in a video when I made it. This one, it does kind of the same thing the last one does, but it unleashes a burst of psychic energy that inflicts confusion on enemies that has the duration of nothing, really. By the time you've come out of it, it's already worn off. Which was, considering how effective some of the other ones is, that was like a slap in the face, to be honest. But it has its perks. The passives, I've lost it. I had it. It was like on the tip of my tongue because I've looked at the skill tree for this one many times. More affinity when killing enemies with melee weapons. Increased crit chance with melee weapons. These are for the duration of the mission once this has first been cast. And The weird one is invisibility when inflicting critical damage with a melee weapon for the duration of the mission. So basically this is definitely set up towards a critical melee weapon. Highly set up for that. It grants allies invisibility for a short period after you use it, which was weird. This is basically more of a stealthy one, which was weird, because it just really is. I mean, the actual ability doesn't really do much, but the perks that come with these do make this a hell of a decent system. An Oryu is a weird one that basically, it's like a ray that turns them into stone, which can come in pretty useful for defense missions. Its passives are weird though, because attacking an enemy with a melee weapon will reduce their armor for the rest of the mission. No, that one's backwards. You've got a chance of petrifying the enemy for the rest of the mission. The reduced armor is for a short period of time after casting this. And then there is the, it grants bonus armor for the duration of the mission, which are its three passives. I mean, increased armor is a hell of a passive. But of course, you have to have cast this thing first, then you will have that. And it does seem pretty nice. It seems based on basically reducing their armor. But again, it seems to be melee weapon based, so you got to be careful what melee weapon you take into missions with you when using these. Then there is Zenuric, which basically releases pulses of void energy that suspend the enemies in midair, kind of like Bastille does. But it does it for a brief period of time, and kind of confused me the first time I actually seen somebody using this one. Its passives seem to be energy based. It increases the efficiency of Warframe abilities for the duration of the mission. Doesn't say for allies though. Though it will restore energy to nearby allies for the duration of the mission. And it replenishes energy for you for the duration of the mission as well. But it does that one periodically. It does seem to have enemy radar built in with, I think it was Rift Sight, which allows you to see the enemy through walls. It also has kind of a bad side to it. It can increase speed, but it reduces the shields. There's actually two. There's one for the player, and there's one for nearby allies. So reducing shield, you can actually bring this out and screw people over by reducing their shields, which could be good, could be bad. It also seems to have Mag's Bullet Attract. I think it's Magnetic Aftershock or something. That basically leaves a void aura on them that will attract bullets, as well as, I think it's called Energy Surge, which will leave a field that replenishes energy to anybody who stands in it, which includes other people on your team. Of course, this does raise a bigger question. How do you actually get this focus stuff? I have asked so many people this, it's been kind of annoying. But, yes, you're supposed to use lenses, and you can get lenses from lots of different places. That's a lie. I have tried everywhere, and the only place I have seen them drop is from the sortie missions. Which is, you've got three of them at the bottom there, the other two are there. But as you can see, yeah. Catalyst Blueprint. Woohoo! A normal lens will get, I think it's like 2.5%. A lens can only be put into a rank 30 weapon or warframe. But if you keep a hold of them, which is what I was trying to do, but the trading channel is full of greedy people. It really is. If you get four of them, you can put them into one of these greater lenses. You do need to buy the blueprint. They are 200,000. It takes a former, an Argon Crystal, an Argon Catalyst, 25 grand on top of this to actually build them, I think. Yeah. And then four of the lenses of that type, which is why you can do the sortie missions and they can drop from that, which is where I got that one from. But when it comes to the thing I'm supposed to be doing, I still only have one. because I just, they, these things are pretty hard to find. But to put them onto a weapon is pretty easy, and I'm probably going to regret this one, but what the hell? This has been out for nearly a week and I haven't earned a single bit of it. Ooh, wrong weapon. Actually, you know what? I'm going to put it into the sonocore because I'm using that thing a lot. Once you put a lens into a weapon, you cannot take it out, but it basically goes in just like a former. Just over here, and make sure you select the right one to the skill tree you are trying to use. And you can see channels affinity into focus for whichever lens you put in. It will put it into that tree. You can obviously unlock them, all the trees. You are not just limited to one, but getting the lenses for them is going to be a pain. Any pre-installed lens will be destroyed. There's no way of taking them out. And just like that, the lens is in. And you can actually see the lens is in because it pops up there. Which nothing else has. You can also put them into, I'm just going to throw on a level 30 frame, Warframes as well, if you have one frame you use all the time. I can't justify doing that at the minute because I don't think I've used Frost for much in quite a while, though I did have to use them for that. But you can see it can also go into frames as well, so you can earn them from there. So theoretically you could put one on everything. You cannot, however, put one onto a Sentinel. What about the Sentinel weapon? Just out of curiosity. Nope, you cannot put them on the Sentinel weapon either. And it's literally, that will now turn 2.5% of the affinity that earns onto that skill tree. Which means I can finally start actually upgrading that skill tree. Also, real quick, if you come to a weapon you've put that on, and you were to former this to fit something else in there, which, to be honest, I probably should, because this thing kind of, it's not as good as it once was. Since update 18, this thing has been just not doing as much damage as it once did. It will not destroy the lens if you drop a former into a weapon with a lens on it, but the lens will not work until it gets back to 30. But the greater lenses do about 6.5 to 7%, whereas a normal one does 2.5. So if you stick normal one on everything that you are carrying, it would be, you would earn more, but if you had a greater lens on everything, you would earn a great deal more.